Hello, peoples of the internet. Today, I will be playing Euro Truck Simulator. And we'll be starting off by doing a job in my lovely Volvo FH16. And then, if all goes well, I'll buy a truck. Although that'll be in the next episode, because I had some issues before and I don't really want the game to crash when I'm trying to record. Now, it looks like there's some places to explore here. I probably explored them already and the game crashed or something, and I'm just going to be irresponsible. Cut in front of that other Volvo. Yeah, I've turned traffic laws off. And I'm revving this truck way too hard because I'm not focusing. Got a DAF dealer there. I don't even know why the traffic lights are blocking me though. Whoa. Missed something there. Can I make the turning? I think I can. Yay! I'm being such an immature driver today. I think it's between 1500 and 20 the truck makes its power. So, that's where I need to web it, really. But I'll probably forget. I have the 750 horsepower engine at the moment, so it gets along pretty decently. As you'll see, we have some jobs. We can do these short ones, I'll just show you this, and then we can do a longer job. Sounds good to me. Probably not to you. But hey, it's my video, I do what I want. We only had a second reversing gear, it's just not quick enough. We press T there, and I've changed the view with one of my number keys, which is not what I wanted to do. So, if we can rev this thing up and indicate. I was driving on the right side of the road this time, which is always convenient, you know. I think I'm in Europe now. I was in the UK, that's where I started out. And you can do specialised parking on this. As I'm reaching my destination very quickly. Oof, please don't damage my trailer. Well, not my trailer, but a trailer. Yeah, I could reverse. I really could reverse, but I thought I would take too much effort. I've not damaged my trailer yet. My truck's a little damaged. But you don't get cosmetic damage. It's only mechanical. Wow, a short job, like the world's shortest job, and I've already made a complete mess of it. Seems like one of my videos. Now, I think I can manage this just about. Probably causing a huge hold up in the traffic. You can look left and right with the numpad keys. Like so. There we go. And I forgot to shift up. So many gears. I can also use F5 to F8 to change these menus and enter to auto park, which I'll be doing in this video because there's not really a point in me doing the long tiring process of parking. Unless, of course, people want to see that, then I might do it. I've got my truck in black here, partially because it hides the plastics, partially because I just like the colour. Now, how long until I need to rest? Yeah, I've got loads of time. And I'm in too high a gear, really. So, let's see what this place has to deliver. Ooh. This seems like a good length of journey to start off with. After that extremely quick thing. Now I can't be bothered to go back in the right way. So I'm doing what the man needs to do. Reversing into the loading area. Nothing unsafe about this. I wonder if you could do an entire journey in reverse. You'd probably be late, but it would be interesting to see if it's possible. And where am I? I'm confused, slightly, little bit. There's my trailer though. So I've incidentally done quite a decent job of connecting it. I say as I fluff the whole thing up. Okay, so I think we need to go that way. No, we need to go that way. Try and keep me webs in right range. And I'm probably breaking the speed limit for this site, but who cares? Breaking speed limits is what I do. I mean, you know, it's not as realistic with the traffic rules off, but it's just so much more fun. As I almost destroyed my trailer. I also have this feature where it automatically turns the indicators off. Don't want to hit that guy's Nissan. It was made in the UK. Sure, if it was built in Japan, I could destroy it. But patriotism. Yeah, I can smash into people's cars, but it'll like damage my truck, so I don't. A lot of time they can drive into me, mainly because I made a stupid mistake and I'm taking up two lanes, I need the space. Since I'm such a terrible driver. I used to be much worse, believe me. I mean, this truck gets along decently quick. We've got a 9-ton load here, as it said when I picked it up. So it's relatively light. It goes from about 4 tons to 24. So it's quite a range of trailers. The lighter loads don't normally pay too well. A lot of my loads, because I believe I'm on the I've got a lot of the high value point things, and I need to turn my lights on, are 12-ish ton trailers. Because, I don't know, I guess that's what high value things are. The points of which I'm speaking, you get certain points and you can spend them on various qualifications, I guess you could say, that allow you to do things. Now we've got 1 hour 30 left apparently. Don't worry, it's not actually 1 hour 30, it's game time, and it will go down in about, I don't know, 5 minutes or something. Now the speed limit's 50, let's go and break it. Whoa. Car. Eek. Cut that a bit too close to the barrier. Yeah, that golf zone at the car speed limit. But I don't obey truck limits, so I'm going at the car speed limit. Probably going above it now. Get back here, golf. You're too quick. Unless it's a 70 road, I'm just thinking. In that case, I'm not going at the car limit yet. But hey, 750 horsepower, and I'll hopefully get a 1200 horsepower truck next, which for some reason it's unlocked on, I think, DAF and maybe other companies, but not on Volvo. I don't get it. But the reason I bought this originally was I had about 3 different truck brands, and Volvo was the most powerful easily. I didn't have a Scania dealer back then, so I couldn't buy a Scania. And that Golf is slowing down, so I have to brake, there's no way out of that. Sometimes I can use the hard shoulder to navigate around them. I know you're not supposed to, but as I said, it's so much more fun when you're going at crazy speeds. I'm taking up too many lanes again. I have got a few lights on this truck that I added, as you might have seen on the menu, but they don't work, which is annoying. Doo-doo-doo. Come on, keep those webs in the right range. I'm foot to the floor now, in case you haven't realised. Come on. Yes, we're blocking the road. Come on, fellow lorrier. Let's block the road. Only it's trucker. I don't know where lorrier came from. Turn into here. Make a line of trucks. And I have to slow down for here because if you fly into those walls, it's not exactly healthy for your truck. There was a mod, I believe, that disables damage completely, but I didn't download that because I wasn't sure about it only working on stock trucks and stuff. I thought because I was going to have a modded engine in here, it might not work. But I don't know, I'll have to look into it. I guess you don't want to see me whamming everyone off the road, though. Hey, if you do, I'm not complaining. Ooh, burn. Wonder if there's a truck dealer here. I'm going out my way, I know. Because there's a thingy up here I want to explore. Wow, I actually went through a traffic light when it was on green. What are the chances of that? And yeah. I should have taken that turning a lot sooner. But it's okay. There's one of the places you can sleep at. Basically, you need rest because sooner or later, if I can ever find the menu, the next rest stop thingy goes down and you need to rest or you just get fined. I don't believe your driver falls asleep as I cut past that Ford. Oh, this is a nice bridge. Kind of nice it went out of the way then, I guess. Go for a red traffic light because there's absolutely no one at the junction. I don't even know why that was on red. Hi, bus. Yeah, I've not assigned my horn yet to the wheel, so I can't honk at people. I might do that for the next video. But for now, let's just end this journey. So, got some money. I think we can do another job and could probably buy a truck. I might do a double episode or something today and then upload them both. I'll have to see. Oh, also, you can get quick jobs where you just do a job for someone else's truck. I think they're normally base models, which is why I love getting a Volvo, because at their least powerful, I believe they're 420 horsepower trucks, which is always handy. And yeah, we're going to now see what other jobs there is. Believe me though, if you get a chance in the quick jobs, use the Iveco. They're hilariously slow. I think it's because it's an older model, so it's not really fair to compare it to like newer technologies and stuff, but it's just so fun when you have to wring everything out of it to go 10 miles per hour up a hill onto a motorway. Whoa, where am I going? No! I forgot brakes existed temporarily there. That could have wrecked my truck flying into an almost invisible wall. Thing I noticed about these Volvo trucks is, they might not be that quick without a trailer, but they don't get any slower when you do have a trailer. And this is probably the place I just came out of. But we have jobs now, so yeah. Now, freight markets. Don't pay that well, but yeah. Let's transport some dry milk. Well, there's also goat cheese here, so it's highly likely it's goat's milk, or rat's milk, or horse milk. And yeah, I stopped in the wrong position. I'm such a disappointment to a trucking community. And yeah, I shifted early there. Time to get going. Speed! The speed of me Volvo. I had a Renault Magnum in a previous life when my old laptop was still in use by me before I sold it. That had integrated graphics and no, I've not smashed my trailer up, which is always nice. Hi Actros. Mercedes Actros. That was a DAF or a MAN, they both look the same. Anything coming? No. Whoa, I forget how to do this stuff. So many keys to press. Still, if you're in the Iveco, there'll probably be a huge traffic jam behind you. I might just buy one of those Ivecos for a joke when it comes to buying the truck. Just because. My team member would have this truck, but I would be driving the appallingly slow Iveco. We're going to turn here, but I'm not going to turn there yet because speed! No, bad decision, bad decision! Almost tipped my truck over. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Yeah, as I was saying earlier, that's why I don't do it. How's my trailer? Ah, that's okay then. I don't have to pay for it if it's only trailer damage, although my truck does eventually get damaged to a point of no repair, I guess, and then that's going to cost me loads of money to repair it. I think your truck starts stuttering and things. I don't know of it ever fully braking. But it will sometimes cut out if you have over 30% damage. I guess I just got lucky on that corner. Because I made a stupid decision and I only got a few percent of damage to my truck. It should only cost me a few thousand to repair that, so I'll make up for that for all the journeys I'm doing. After this journey I'll show you how the Westing mechanic works. And some other bits and bobs, I guess. Oh, we've got to slow down. Hard shoulder! As I said, hard shoulders are useful. Although that might not have been a hard shoulder. Might have been another lane. I think it's a hard shoulder. And whoa, 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 whoa. Hit someone's Peugeot. Times are being mean to me. I'll show you the repair physics as well. Mechanics, I don't know, my mind's not functioning. And then you'll see how it repairs your truck when you get it damaged. Amazingly though, my trailer is still fine. Just if only this truck had more powerful brakes for my crazy, crazy driving. Looks like no one else is on the road, maybe I can clip the apex. As they say. Wow, it's almost midnight. So, cut to the inside because I can. Then we want to go. No, you're not cutting into my waiting line, Peugeot van. Well, it could be a Citroen, they look the same. I think it's a Peugeot. Racing on my street vehicle. Street racing. And then we're going to I'm on the brakes, but I hit 63 miles per hour, so it's okay. And yeah. Oh no, I'm shifting down and the problem was I was in too low a gear. I was just being stupid. By the end of this journey, I'll probably have a door hanging off my truck, but an immaculate trailer. Because that's how I roll. Got a long journey here to deliver this stuff. Some journeys have ferry routes on, and I don't believe a company pays for that, weirdly enough. So, if there's a ferry on your route, you're paying for it. In the quick jobs, they do pay for your fuel, but in the standard mode, the flight mode even, you have to pay for your own fuel. Thankfully, these Volvos are incredibly efficient. I rarely have to refuel them, and it's normally under about 2,000 credits when I have to, which I easily make back in the jobs I do, so yeah. Volvos are good trucks. I believe you can also get a nicer interior, but I'm cheap and I spent all my money on the engine and the upgraded transmission. So that's why I've got the boring basic truck and interior, but with the top end engine and transmission. Because speed. That van is finally giving me a slip. Not for long though. Not for long. Whoa. Yeah, hey, I would have either hit that truck or hit the wall. I took probably the more stupid option, but still. Yeah, you get the idea. My driving just isn't very good and I end up hitting things all the time. And I'm probably causing a traffic jam in the middle of the night. Well, it's almost one, really. There's a Scania. Volvo! Also, I have this Rocket League ball thing hanging there. Hope you saw that. It's a nice little thing, so when I look left, I can see it. It only costs about 100 credits. It's a fun thing. It's like a Rocket League promo thingy. And yep. I did want to get the toy Volvo truck, which is a mod, but it doesn't seem to work. So I'm a bit sad about that. I'm going to turn into here. And slow down. Because we know what happened last time we tried the speed approach into a tight hairpin. Come on. I know I'm revving it a bit too high, but it's moving. Wait, forget road laws, this is probably quicker. I'm a dangerous man. No, I'm being overtaken by old Peugeots. And we've still got 3 hours left. 3.5 hours even. But these are country roads. If I get a good slope, I can fly down them. And believe me, I've been at 80 miles per hour in this truck under the right circumstances. And I've not tipped the truck over on this account. I've tipped one over on my old laptop. But these are the modern days where I can actually handle ultra settings and not lowest settings. And resolution. Well, I think it was 1366 by 768, but I was getting about 18 frames per second or something on lowest settings. It wasn't great, but then the throttle memory probably didn't help. It's not a demanding game, to be honest. The reason I used to play it back in the day was it I knew it ran quite well and I had this fascination with PC gaming, but couldn't afford a decent PC. This PC is good, and it was made in the UK, which you can't see from any laptops. Yes, I'm Indiana Truck. Time's flying down now. I'm going at 70 miles per hour on a country road. Quite a good road to go the speed on, if I'm honest. I'm in 12th gear, top gear. Can't shift any higher than that. Whoa. I think I'm going to have to brake, unfortunately. Not just a corner, but something's in front of me. Shift down to 11. Overtake! Whoa, dramatic overtake! Whoa. Yeah, I meant to turn for that corner. My truck's become a bit of a mess after we crashed it. Oh, oh. That did not feel comfortable. And I've damaged my trailer for the first time, and I was just trying to take a corner. Forget when I almost tipped over a truck. I go over a curb and my trailer gets damaged. Foot to the floor now. 22 miles per hour. 23. 24. Come on. Come on, mighty Volvo. Don't lose revs. And we're picking up speed again. Torque. Give me all your torque. Go for a light on amber. Still flashing amber. Maybe there's something wrong with it. And we're up to speed again by the looks of it. As I slow down. Just as I say I'm up to speed, a truck starts to lose loads of speed. And we've got a bit of downhill section. Speed. Speed, glorious speed. Just how do we do it? Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Got speed, glorious speed, glorious speed. Breaking the speed limit, cause speed, speed is perfect. I'm through speed. Hour 34 left, and 5 hours 22 until I have to rest. I could do another job at this rate. Oh, 256. I just saw that then. I'm like, hey, I have 256 megabyte memory modules in my Pentium 3 machine. 301. I have 300 and something in there now. It's two 256s, of which it recognises 128 megabytes, and a 64 because one of them started acting up. And I can't math, and I'm going the wrong way. So, yeah. Instead of doing the sensor thing and finding another route, I'm just going to do the lazy person thing and turn around in the middle of the road in a HGV. How did I miss that by so far? I guess I was talking and not looking at the GPS. I'll probably miss it again. Go back on the motorway to where I came from and then realise I've gone the wrong way. Oh, also, we have remaining time, as you'll see above rest stop. You might have noticed that before. It's basically how long do you have to deliver the stuff. So I've got loads of time because I have a really quick lorry, even with the mistakes I'm making. So we're going to indicate, not that anyone's coming. and turn in here, shift down a bit, shift up again. No, it's a toll road. Fooled me. Last time I went on some country lanes instead of a toll road. Yeah. I don't really judge the brakes. Oh dear. Really? Don't tell me I have to pay the toll again. This is actually whipping me off. I just paid the toll. No, I don't think it's charged me again. That's okay then. My truck is pretty beaten. So, let's go up here and onto the motorway. There's a lot of motorways in this game. I think we spend too long on them, to be honest. There is a map, though, which I'll show you now. If you want to take a more interesting route, you can say, I'm not going that way and just go around there, which I probably should have. No, there's two toll booths. Probably best I don't then. I don't know, if I came from up there, I could probably have gone round here. Toll roads everywhere on this route though, which is disgraceful. Indicating. I don't know why my brakes feel so useless though. Am I just not used to it? Have I been playing too much Forza and got used to full-on race braking? And I expect my truck to do it. Also, internet radio. Something I've not really shown you yet. And we can get all this stuff. BBC radios here, Radio 3, Radio 2, copyright, so I can't play them now, but I'll just have to sing, I guess, and make several birds die in the process. And I'm losing revs, no, don't drop below 1450 RPM, I need that torque. There we go, picking up webs again. Gotta clip this apex round here. Damn. I wonder if anyone's modded a racing truck. I don't think they have. And yeah, I'm braking early this time. Still might not be enough. And just coast to a stop here. Haul off €7. Some of them are whip off, some of them are like €28 to go through a toll road. I mean, who's going to pay that? €28, you could buy a beautifully handmade sandwich. I could make a beautiful handmade sandwich for about £5. Well, maybe not beautiful if it was €5. £5 I could. Although, to say my sandwich is beautiful is probably stretching it a bit. But I just want to go quick and stop talking about sandwiches because it's kind of making me hungry when I'm not hungry. In a way I can't really explain. Wobble, wobble, wobble. I just felt like doing that. I know I'm weird. Weave out. I think I'm past my point of sanity now. Maybe this is why I don't drive yet. I don't know. Well, mainly that's for medical reasons. But still, there's other reasons I don't drive, clearly. Like that. I love me wasting truck on Forza, if only this was that powerful. I can turn my lights off because it's getting bright. And so we're almost there. I was in this lane and I need to brake. Brake, 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 brake. Looks like I'm going through this way because I've completely messed it up. Well, I'm guessing I'm on the right side of the road. That helps. Ooh, I'm in Metz. Red traffic lights, them don't stop me. And then it looks like we've got to go in here. Come on, come on. Whoa, into here. Trying to keep as much pace as I realistically can. And enter. We've arrived in a satisfactory way. That's only because of the damage though. If I didn't damage it, it would have been better. But yeah. I think there's one or two more things I need to do. And then I can round off this episode. Broom, broom. Here we have a repair garage, maybe a rest stop as well, which is handy for what I need to show you. And stop. So, we've got to service the truck here. There's all the cost of my damages. And we can also get upgrades, which I'll show you. Here's the interior. I could buy that, but since I'm going to replace the truck, it seems kind of pointless. So much more luxury though. I'm pretty sure I saw a different interior though. That has to be said on one of the borrowed trucks. Maybe it's just me. Ooh, racing stripes. These are just some liveries I can go for. Kind of like that one. Looks a bit strange, but it works. Looks like a caravan. And don't think that does anything without messing with the colour. We can get some accessories. There's my number plate, which says my name on it. I'm not sure if that's supposed to be the truck or something, but it's not showing up. Standard plate, yeah. Telepass devices. I believe this will be from a modification to the game file. There we go, we can enter stuff. Platent telepass devices. You know what? I'll give my co-drive, my imaginary co-driver, a name. They're not imaginary, really. They're just invisible, okay? No! One letter, that's all I needed. Fine. Yes, I can fit Squidward in. Squidward's my co-driver. If we look at that from the outside... What else can we get? Oh dear, am I still on the Lux interior? I don't know. Why does they have to pay so much? The livery? There we go. Get some chrome on me truck. Can get some wheels as well. They look like the basic wheels and automation. One of them did. Those ones. Dualies. I think we'll be fine with the standard wheels for now. But I'll buy some chrome mirrors and a Squidward plate. So now we can go and rest, I believe, in these parking bays. So I'll just show you how this looks. There's me and there's Squidward. So, I'll get some rest, show you how this works. You can do it if you're inside the interior as well. You press enter multiple times if you want your driver to get a bit more sleep. So, I believe that's it for today's episode. And until next time, goodbye everyone.